because you're raising money from these traditional Republican donors, there's a fear that you're leaving your progressive roots behind, which was sort of, it was emblematic that you visited the Harvard Club yesterday. It sort of underscores that move away from traditional Democratic values, don't you think?
I think that's actually the, I don't think that's right, Susan. I think it is a very important point, but I don't think it's that I'm less of a Democrat. I think what you're seeing is you have a schism within the Republican Party. They, you have the Republican Party is searching for an identity. They're searching to define their soul. That's what's going on. Is the Republican Party in this state a moderate party, or is it an extreme conservative party? That's what they're trying to figure out. And it's very interesting because it's a mirror of what is going on in Washington, right? The gridlock in Washington is less about Democrats and Republicans. It's more about extreme Republicans versus moderate Republicans. And the moderate Republicans in Washington can't figure out how to deal with the extreme Republicans, and the moderate Republicans are afraid of the extreme conservative Republicans in Washington, in my opinion. You're seeing that play out in New York. The SAFE Act, the Republican Party candidates are running against the SAFE Act. It was voted for by moderate Republicans who run the Senate. Their problem is not me and the Democrats. Their problem is themselves. Who are they? Are they these extreme conservatives who are right to life, a pro-assault weapon, anti-gay? Is that who they are? Because if that's who they are, and if they are the extreme conservatives, they have no place in the state of New York.
So this,
because that's not who New Yorkers are. If they're moderate Republicans, like in the Senate right now, who control the Senate, moderate Republicans have a place in this state. George Pataki was governor of the state as a moderate Republican, but not what you're hearing from them on the far right, not this clash that you're getting from the quote-unquote power brokers of the party now. We are right to life. We are pro-assault weapon or anti.
Are you talking about Republican Ed Cox?
Whoever. I'm just look at their positions, and you see a great battle of positions that were that are now being criticized that were passed by the moderate Republicans in the Senate, you know. And that's what's going to play out this year. Who are the Republicans? And who wins between the extreme conservatives and the moderates?
This week, Ed Cox did urge his fellow Republicans not to endorse you. Yesterday, you spoke to Republicans at the Harvard Club. Is there a connection there?
Well, that was planned anyway. I think he did that in reaction to the meeting we were having. But, you know, moderate Republicans I work with. Moderate Republicans passed my agenda for the past 3 years. They want to criticize my record. My record was passed by the moderate Republicans. So they're criticizing themselves.
Have you?
So this really isn't about me, Susan. This is who are they? And who's going to win between the conservative Republicans, extremely conservative Republicans, and the moderately conservative Republicans, and literally look at the issues that they pick. Are we right to life, or are we pro-choice? Well, if you're right to life, and that's your opinion, and that's your religious belief, that's fine, but that's not the opinion of this state. This state is 70% a choice, pro-choice state. Well, we're anti-gun control. That's fine. 70% of this state wants intelligent gun control. Well, we don't agree with gay marriage. We're anti-gay. That's fine. But 70% of this state about is now pro-gay marriage. So figure out who you are and figure out if your extreme conservative philosophy can survive in this state? And the answer is no.